today over differences between two youth groups. Well, trouble started when members of the Amaza-wuti group allegedly stormed a house where those of the train group had camped for the night. Meanwhile, an 18-year-old matric learner was hacked to death, while five others there sustained injuries following that gang violence. Well, for an update on that story, we cross now to our reporter, that's Zimkhitha Manqinana, who's in that area. Good afternoon, Zimkhitha. Tell us what's happening in Sterkspruit right now.
Good afternoon, Kirshni, and welcome to Sterkspruit. Well, we're coming to you from one of the houses that were torched yesterday. They lost everything. These two groups were actually formed for a good initiative. One was formed to assist police in terms of crime prevention strategies in the rural areas. The other one was formed for sporting activities and cultural dance. But now what we are seeing, Kirshni, is the influence of gang violence against these two groups who are not seeing eye to eye, and those issues of not seeing eye to eye have now led to nine houses being torched and one person being murdered. But we're just going to get more detail from the MEC Pemima Jordina, who has been in this area to assess, and she actually brought social workers to these areas to counsel those people who lost absolutely everything from some of the damages that happened yesterday. MEC, good afternoon and welcome. Just tell us, this group were formed with a good initiative, but we see now things have turned otherwise. What's really happening here?
Thank you very much for having me. It is a very devastating action that has happened last night here, where people were lost everything. And for us as government, we are saying, when the initiative of forming this group was set, it was not supposed to be what it is now. It has turned to be a gang-related violence and gang wars, which now has affected ordinary people who are not even part of those gangs. The elderly people at the age of 90 have lost everything. And as government, we are condemning with all possible means that this has happened. And we are saying, let the community come down, because we don't want revenge killings and revenge torching, because that is what the community is aiming at. But fortunately, we have initiated that we must have a task team, police, that are going to take up all these cases. There are very serious cases that have happened here, as back as 2006, that community are not happy about. Hence now, they are boiling with a lot of anger because of the past happenings that has occurred in this area.
Okay, before we get into those issues that made them boil up to such incidents, where are you going to place these grandmothers and children who are now homeless after the torching of their houses?
The Department of Human Settlement is on board, where we are going to intervene swiftly in terms of providing temporal accommodation. But at the moment, we have requested them to stay with families and friends, because we don't want to put them under one roof in a community center, because at the moment, the situation, you cannot confirm what is going to happen. Be that as may, they are safe at the moment, because we have subs patrolling the area. For the next few days, they'll be around the area, but six of the suspects have already been arrested. And to me, that's a breakthrough, because we want to send a clear signal to all criminals, either of the group, who are going to arrest everybody that has made us to be in this situation.
What are those issues, ma'am, that have made them to boil up, to end up in such incidents that are now leaving people destitute?
They are not really disclosing, except that they terrorize one another. Whenever they meet, there is a control of the terrain sort of a claim that you cannot pass this area, this is my area. And to us, there is no one that can control others not to go and enjoy wherever they want to enjoy. But also, we're very much worried about the taverns that are open 24 hours in this area. And you have elderly people who sit in those taverns. And to us, that is just not on. There are drugs here, there are illegal weapons that are harbored in this area. And we are saying, we are not going to leave any stone unturned. We're going to deal with each and everything and clean up all these gangs.
Thank you very much for your time. While we continue to assess the situation here, we'll bring you those news as they come and happen. It's back to you in Johannesburg, Kirshni.
Well, that was our reporter Zimkhitha, of course, monitoring that situation in Sterkspruit, Eastern Cape Force, where gang violence, there we understand, has led to the torching of 9 homesteads. Well, the SAPS Wearing is patrolling the area. There's a very strong presence in the area right now. A task team also has been set up to deal with such gang-related violence, and 6 suspects, we understand, have been arrested so far. We'll be bringing you regular updates on that story as it develops. But for now, let's take a look at those temperatures.